Welcome to today's Meat Science class. In the last lecture, I started discussing about meat processing. I have already discussed in part 1 about the basic aspects of meat processing, preparation of meat emulsion, different type of meat products, and some of the aspects of cooking which is required for all kind of processed meats. So today in the part 2, exclusively, I am going to talk about comminuted meat products. I have already told comminuted meat products means where the meat is ground into small particles, especially with mincing and followed by bowl chopping. So this comminuted meat products can be made only with grinding without emulsion, or sometime we can do with emulsion. So it can be very coarse type of comminuted meat products when it is only mincing, or sometime it is fine type with emulsion. So we call them emulsion type meat products. So one of the most common comminuted meat products is sausages. The term sausage came in old days from Latin word salsas, which means addition of salt. So those days they used to grind the meat manually and add salt and stuff it into casings. That's the origin of sausages. Later there are a lot of changes happened. So we can do it by mincing and seasoned meat formed into cylindrical shape. That is how the sausage is defined. Meat product prepared by mincing and seasoning and forming into cylindrical shape, especially using the natural casing that is from the animal intestine. Nowadays there are synthetic casings are also available. So basically this kind of meat product, sausages, as you see here in the picture, they are of Western origin, especially of European countries, and later they became very popular in every parts of the world. So even in India also, slowly this is gaining popularity, and in all big cities or metro cities, in all big malls, supermarkets, different kind of sausages are available even from other countries. So some way these sausages are economical because initially it was started with the use of lower value cuts. So some meat which is not preferred by people, that can be ground and made into sausage, or some of the edible byproducts can be used. So that is how those low value cuts become more valuable, and now popularly we call value added meat products. So quickly I will talk about the classification, because there are many varieties of sausages in different countries of different origin, and they are difficult to classify. So popular way of classification on different basis, like based on the degree of chopping. So if there is very fine chopping, then it is emulsion type sausage, but without emulsion we call it ground sausage or coarse ground sausage. Similarly, about the content of moisture, we can call dry sausage or semi-dry sausage. Based on cooking, it can be fresh sausage, cooked sausage, or smoked sausage. Sometimes smoked, uncooked, sometimes smoked and cooked, like that different varieties. Sometime briefly I will tell some of them. And based on fermentation, so sometime fermented sausage, raw sausage, fresh sausage, cooked sausage, even fermented sausage or non-fermented sausages. Here is a standard recipe. So recipe can be modified as per the requirement of the people, or as per the demand of the people, or as per the choice or taste of the local people. So that's why recipe varies in different countries. Even it varies with the availability of raw materials and different kind of spices we prefer. So in general, this gives an idea about the recipe, like meat about 85% and fat 15%. But same recipe can be done in other way, like everything together it should be 100. But in this case, what we did is total meat and fat together is 100. Over that, all the other ingredients are added. I will show you another recipe where it will be total 100. So here meat is about 85, fat or oil 15. Over that, salt, sugar, phosphate. So it should not exceed 0.5% in the finished product. Dry spices, chili powder, ginger powder, green condiments. So this is in Indian context, we use onion, ginger, garlic paste. But this may not be suitable for some people abroad. Maida is used as a binder, and chilled water is used for chopping, and the temperature is good if we have a chilled water or ice. So here is the process flow for preparation of sausages. The first part, like making the emulsion, I have already discussed in the part 1. So first there will be cutting the meat. Like if it is frozen meat, we have to cut into chunks. Then it will go through mincer. So it is the first grinding. Then it goes to the bowl chopper, where all other ingredients are added and meat protein is extracted. And later fat is added to make the emulsion. Now once the emulsion is ready, it will be filled into casing. So this is a sausage stuffer, a cylinder type with a hydraulic operation, and the animal intestine is already processed and made into casing in which the batter is stuffed into. So once stuffing is done, then it goes through another process called linking. So here this whole length will be subdivided into smaller units. So that process is called linking. All this thing we are going to show you in the practical class. And before that, it will be explained in more details in separate lectures. Now after linking, this is ready. We can keep it in storage for direct marketing without cooking, or we can go for cooking. As I told earlier, it can be cooked in steam, or we can go for smoking and cooking in the same chamber, and after which it will go for chilling and packaging. So here are some of the popular sausages. Fresh pork sausage, as I said, so it will not be cooked. Generally, it will be coarse ground, so there will be no emulsion. Mostly lean pork trimmings, that is the cuttings and small cuttings around the carcass and back fat, that is mainly used. Frankfurters, as the name indicates, it is the origin of Frankfurt in Germany. And here it is cured and emulsion type. So emulsion will be made. The main component is beef trimmings and pork trimmings. Then there is salami, which is again fresh and emulsion type, but sometimes there is a fermented type of salami, which I am going to talk later. Here mainly pork trimmings, pork cheek meat is used. The detailed recipe of all this product is given in the notes, so you should read from that. Here the batter is stuffed in broad casings, especially weasand prepared from the esophagus. Then it undergoes smoking and cooking simultaneously. Then chicken sausages, it is emulsion type. Chicken meat and vegetable oil is used here. Then Bologna, this is a place in Italy. So Italy is very famous for processed meat products. This is also an emulsion type of sausage prepared from the meat of old animal. So old animal meat, it will be very tough and it will not be preferred. So grinding makes it tender. And once we make it emulsion with other ingredients, it becomes very flavorful and it becomes a value added meat product. Hot dog, this is a very popular name of sausage. It is a very spicy sausage and filled in broad casings, usually weasand, that is prepared from esophagus. Mortadella, this is again a popular sausage. It is generally dry or fermented sausage. I am going to talk about it later. This is again filled into broader casings. So this is briefly about the sausage aspect. Now there is another kind of product. This is also comminuted meat product, that is called meat nuggets. So nuggets means actually lumps. Actually they call nuggets of gold. So a lump of gold, from which probably this term has come. So this is also a ready to eat emulsion type meat product. And the recipe will be almost similar as I have shown in the part 1 and today for the sausage. We can make slight changes. Like here it will be sometime used into a box, so we can use more water to get more yield. So meat emulsion is prepared in the same way as I have discussed in the part 1 and today for the sausage. Now in a small scale preparation of nuggets, the emulsion is filled into rectangular mold, like tiffin box, stainless steel tiffin box. We can fill it and we can cook it in steam or hot water. After cooking, we can cool it and then we can open the box and we get a solid block. That is what we are telling nuggets. After which we can cut into pieces and pack it in polythene pouches, which can be stored in refrigerator. If it is 4 degree, up to 2 weeks, but if it is above 4 degree, maybe up to 10 days. These nuggets can be used as snack for direct consumption after frying, or it can be used for making gravy like dishes to use with rice or chapati or bread. But this is for small scale preparation of nuggets. For large scale, for commercial preparation, there are big size batter making machine or bowl chopper, and there are automatic continuous forming machine and frying machine. So continuously it will form different size, shape and size with different kind of molds, and frying will be done in the fryer line, which I am going to show. So this is what we do in small scale in our laboratory. It is going to be explained again, and we are going to show you in the practical. So this is the mold, this is filled with the batter, then after cooking is the block, and this is the pieces which is packed for retail marketing. So here is a standard recipe for nuggets. Here you can see total made into 100. So lean pork 65, fat 15, ice flakes 10, and other things together makes 100. But this picture is the commercial nuggets, where there is a coating and then it is fried. So the earlier one is a small scale in laboratory. This is in large scale in the industry, where a breadcrumb like coating is made and then it is fried in the automatic frying lines. So here you can see different kind of nuggets. So it is mainly due to the change of mold. So we can have star shape or heart shape or round shape or square shape. Many different shape and size we can do by changing the mold in the automatic forming machine for nuggets, and later it is fried in the fryer line. So this is automatic line where different shape and size will be formed automatically and come. After that it goes to the fryer where it will be fried, and then the finished product will come out. So here is another meat product, that is meatballs. Originally in India we used to make old days meatballs, which they used to call it as kofta. So they will simply grind with hand mincer and mix with fat and other spices and make it a ball. So here the batter is prepared by ground meat, salt, fat, sometime breadcrumb or wheat flour, some condiments, spices, and everything can be mixed in food mixer. So in small scale we can do it without bowl chopper. Mixing, first we can do the hand mincing, and then we can mix everything in food mixer along with the spices and condiments. Then we can make 15 to 20 gram size of balls manually by hand. And nowadays there are mechanical machines which I am going to show. Now these raw balls can be stored in deep fridge and marketed like that, or they can be cooked either in hot water or in deep frying. So deep frying means around 135 to 150 degree Celsius is better, not beyond that, and 3 to 4 minutes is enough. So frying will give a better flavor or taste, whereas it can be cooked in hot water also, around 80 degree Celsius for 20 minutes, and then we can take them cool and pack them. So they can be packed in polythene pouches and can be stored up to 2 weeks at 4 degree Celsius. These kind of balls can be fried and used as snack, or it can be used for making gravy. So old days they used to make handmade kofta, which they will make as curry and use for bread or chapati or rice. So here you can see modern automatic meatball forming machine, where there is a stainless steel chamber and the batter will be made, and from here automatically the balls will come out. The similar things are also available in continuous forming machine, which I have shown for the nuggets, and then that goes to directly to the deep frying. So this is the commercial meatball making machine nowadays available. Then another meat product, that is meat patties. So this is a flat and round type. Nowadays it is very popular for as a burger patty, but earlier days In India, they used to make it like the cutlet. So they used to grind the meat manually, mix with the spices and vegetables and condiments, and make it a round ball. Then flatten it and fry it either on the tawa as a shallow fry, and then that is used as a snack. That was Indian practice, like cutlet. But same thing in Western countries, they do it by more fine grinding and mixing with spices, and that can be made into flat. So it can be ground, that is without emulsion, or with emulsion, both type. It may have up to 30% fat in earlier days, but nowadays the fat content is reduced due to health concern, and preferably we try to keep it within 15% of fat. So meat is minced through 4 mm plate and then mixed with other ingredients in food mixer, and then we can get a batter, or we can do in the bowl chopper to make a emulsion, as I have discussed earlier. So here about 70 to 80 gram of batter is taken, and it is flattened into 70 to 80 mm diameter flat size, and the thickness will be about 15 to 20 millimeter. Now these are raw. Here again the automatic forming machine for patties. They can be frozen and packed and frozen and kept it for marketing as such, or sometime it can be cooked in the automatic frying line, as I have shown for the nuggets. Same way it can be deep fried in the automatic fryer around 160 degrees Celsius for 40 minutes. So this is the automatic frying line. Sorry, this frying time, there is a mistake. It should be 4 minutes. This is the automatic frying line. After that, raw patties is coming out. It goes through a fryer and you can see the finished product coming out. So here is a recipe. This recipe, as I said, can be modified as per requirement. Here lean meat is 65, fat 15, soya, texturized soya is added for making patties, or sometime we can add wheat flour or mashed potato. To increase the bulk, we can use mashed potato. Several other binders and extenders can be used depending on the availability and plan. So this is a smaller size but automatic patty forming machine. So here we have to feed the dough, and then automatically it will have the molding and coming out. This is another one, meat loaves. So this is like to make it like bread, meat loaves. So this is also a ready to eat comminuted meat product prepared from ground meat or emulsion. So we can make the mincing and mixing in the food mixer, and we can do it, or we can do as a emulsion as normal batter preparation. So this formulation may have little bit of more wheat flour, but the process is almost same. The batter is filled in aluminium container or steel mold of different shape and size. So we may have it rectangular or square size or star shape or hexagonal shape, different shape of mold that will be filled with the batter where we have little bit of more amount of wheat flour or breadcrumb, and after filling it will be closed with a lid. Preferably we should have a butter paper lining inside, and then it is cooked in hot air oven. So this is a dry heat cooking, that is like baking, as bread is done in baking. So dry heat cooking around 165 degrees Celsius, and because it is a big lump, it may take more time, sometime 2 hours depending on the size and volume of the mold. It may take 2 to 3 hours, and the internal temperature should reach at least 70 degrees Celsius. After cooking, the mold should be taken out, it should be cooled down, and we will get a bread like shape, and that can be sliced like bread of desired thickness, and that can be packed. So this kind of slice can be directly consumed, or we can use it for making sandwiches, bread sandwiches. Now the last part of this today's lecture, that is fermented meat products. These type of products are very popular in Western countries, especially in Europe, Germany, France, Spain, Italy, Netherlands. So they can be two type. One is dry or another is semi-dry sausages. They are most popular and most common fermented meat products. So dry means it will have a moisture of around 30%, maximum 40%. Semi-dry means it will have a moisture 40 to 50%. So this summer sausage, they are some of the name of fermented sausages like summer sausage, dry salami, pepperoni, mortadella, cured and fermented. So mortadella is a cured and fermented sausage. So these are all popular name of fermented meat products. In India, during the earlier days when we had Dutch rule, that time they developed a very simple fermented type of sausage in Goa, which is very popular today, that is called Goa sausage. So the fermented sausages, here a starter culture is added. So first a batter is made, then the starter culture is added, then it is filled into the casing and allowed it to ferment. So there will be growth of lactic acid bacteria and acidity will be produced. So because of the growth of bacteria, it will metabolize some simple sugars, some maltose. Simple sugar is added in the batter. The bacteria will grow on that and metabolize. That will produce lactic acid and that gives specific tangy flavor, which is preferred by the people. Here pH is reduced and accumulation of lactic acid, so there will be preservation. And moreover, after the fermentation, it is allowed for drying at a low humidity, sometime for semi-dry about 5 days and dry for 10 days. So with this process, the moisture level will go down and it can be stored in dry sausages. It can be stored even without refrigeration. So dry sausages are not cooked sometime. So here is the process I have already explained: preparation of emulsion, then addition of culture, there is a mistake, then it will be filled into the casing. On the other side, the culture will be made ready and then it will be added into the batter and filled into the casing, and then it will be left for fermentation. After that, there will be cooking or drying. In case of dried sausage, there will be no cooking, and then the product will be ready. So here are some of the popular brands which is producing different kind of meat and meat products, like Venky's, Suguna, Godrej, Shanti, Diamond, Pioneer, and this is Horinghatta Meats. It is under the government of West Bengal, which is becoming very popular and making different kind of meat products and marketing in West Bengal and sometime in other parts of India. So briefly today I have explained about different type of comminuted meat products. You should read the details from the notes, and I will come back with the next lecture, that is non-comminuted meat products. Thank you. Thank you very much.